You may consider that the evidence revealed the defendant not to be a vulnerable schoolboy, but rather a vicious and dangerous rapist. But doesn't it show that having gained a taste for the power that his horrific sexual attack could inflict, the defendant attempted the rape of Mrs. Nancy Osborne? Wasn't it him who subjected John Paul McQueen to a sustained campaign of bullying and abuse, culminating in the devastating attack you have heard described? Isn't it the case that Mr. McQueen offered guidance and support to a troubled and disturbed young man, and that his reward for the compassion he showed was to be brutally and cold-heartedly raped?
Finn O'Connor, a vulnerable and confused schoolboy, you may think, who did no more than place his trust in a teacher who blurred the boundaries of acceptable behavior, whose interest in Finn O'Connor wasn't compassion, but lust, a teacher who began a calculated course to groom him for sexual favors. I invite you to conclude that Mr. McQueen is someone with a track record for targeting schoolboys, for corrupting them and coercing them for his own gratification. And when his sordid life came crashing down, didn't he concoct a false allegation to cover up his own depraved and sickening crimes? And when my client's name was sullied with this allegation, Miss Nancy Osborne pointed the finger at an easy target. Having made one false allegation against Robert Roscoe, she quickly made another against Finn O'Connor. An accusation with no substance and no evidence to support it. I therefore invite you to find my client not guilty on both counts.
I must ask you now to retire to the jury room and consider your verdict.
How's Nancy?
Well, they've reached a verdict, so we're going back in. I'll make sure she's okay.
She's not my wife, you know. What she went through. If she doesn't get justice, I just want to hold her and tell her everything's going to be all right.
Well, I think you need to respect what she wants and give her some space.
Yeah, but I should be in there. That sick, twisted little... Yeah, what he did to the woman I love, I just want to see him punished for that.
We'll do it then, hmm? Sit in the gallery. You know, what Finn did affects you too.
Yeah, but Nancy...
Well, she's angry now. And I don't know if she'll ever be able to get over it. You know what? She's part of your life forever. You've got kids. And one day they're all going to ask about this. And they're going to want to know whether or not you were there for her. And when that day comes, she'd like to be able to say yes.
Would the foreman please stand? Madam Foreman, have you reached verdicts on which you were all agreed?
We have.
On the first count of the rape of Mr. John Paul McQueen, do you find the defendant guilty or not guilty?
Guilty.
Yes!
Quiet, please! Quiet!
And on the second count of the attempted rape of Miss Nancy Osborne, do you find the defendant guilty or not guilty?
Guilty.
I will adjourn until the pre-sentencing report is ready. Until then, you are remanded in custody. Take him down.
No. No! No, this is all your fault! I hate you!
I'm sorry.
It turns out the truth was enough. All those lies that they told about me,